lads, like three scurvy dogs that we are.
Aye, looting and pillaging and sailing the high seas.
Aye, hoist the mainsail, swab the decks, clean the head, what a life.
Steal from the rich and keeping it for ourselves.
Aye, what's gotten into you anyway, heister?
Aw, nothing, but pirating ain't all treasure hunts and midnight raids. Most of the time it's work, work, work. Clean this, polish this, fix me some grub.
Pipe down for the captain's ears.
Aye, what's your point anyway?
Me point is, there's something better for us out there. Something that'll make us captains of our own ships.
Aye, what's better than this anyway?
This is, mates. It's a map that leads to treasure beyond our wildest imaginations.
Aye, we're pirates, ain't we? Let's go dig it up.
Let's go then.
It's not buried treasure.
Even better, it's just laying around, we go get it.
Aye.
Wrong. It's five levels up in something called a warehouse.
We could climb up and carry it down.
Or tie a rope onto it and pull it down.
Brilliant, you blokes. Why didn't I think of that? Idiots, you can't climb up there and get it. You can't climb on rats. You could injure yourself. Or even worse, or you could pull it down and break the treasure or hurt one of us.
All right, then what's your plan?
Well, I haven't got one. But someone put it there. We just need to figure out how, and without the captain finding out.
It's too late for that, you lily-livered scum. I heard the whole plan. I know how you can get your treasure, and I'll tell you, for a cut of the loot, for the lot of you can walk the plank.
Well, since you put it that way, you're in.
Ah, wise decision. Now, what you need to get your treasure is a forklift.
A what?
A forklift. It's used to transport and locate material in a warehouse, even lifted it five stories up, so idiot pirates like you can't get to it.
Arr, let's get one of these forklifts and go get the treasure.
Aye, let's get started.
Slow down, you sprog. You don't just go get a forklift. First, you need a forklift license.
Well, how do we get one of them?
Well, you have to go through forklift training class. Then you get your license.
Arr, let's go get trained so we can go get the treasure down.
Aye!
Yo ho, yo ho, a pirate's life.
Here we are, lads. Now pay attention, or I'll leave you here and take the treasure for myself.
Aye, Captain.
Good morning, class. Welcome to Forklift 101. I'm your instructor, Mr. Chisholm.
Morning, Mr. Chisholm.
All right, now pay attention, because there's going to be a test afterwards. We're going to talk about the lower...
Captain, this ain't nothing but no testing.
Aye, maybe there's another way to get her license.
And if you don't have the center of gravity correct, you can overturn the trucks. This is where it should be, right here. You see it? And when it moves, that's when the load's going to tip over.
I say we teach Mr. Chisholm something a little bit about pirates.
Aye.
Aye, in their hands. Did you get your 30-day licenses then?
Aye, we did.
It's a miracle to be sure. Now, let's go test out what you learned in your class and sign out your forklift.
Aye, we did, Captain.
No. Do you learn nothing from your training? Before you can take the work truck, you gotta inspect it to make sure it's in good working order.
Right you are, Captain. Inspecting like swabbing the deck. In shining the brass like the noonday sun.
No. Inspect it. Like making sure there's no leaks in the mast or that the steering's in good working order. Or, you know, it's all right here in this safety inspection sheet. You just go through and mark off as you go.
Let me see this. Hey, Raymond, you checked the battery connections, lights, gauges, and horns. Heister, you checked the hydraulic controls, brakes, tires, condition. I'll take a look at the overhead protector, and the fire extinguisher, and then I'll plug any holes I find.
Plug in holes? What are you talking about? Stick to the list, and the maintenance will take care of all the repairs.
Well, it says plug in right there.
Oh, that's not what it means. Plug-in refers to the forward and reverse lever. Now let's get going before I keel-haul all you landlubbers.
Mr. Chisholm, relax. Describe these guys to me again.
Well, they had earrings and had been
bandanas and puffy shirts. And one of them had an eye patch and a sword. And they said things like, Aaarrggh, and I, and they even called me a scurvy dog. They stole all my temporary license, and I'm just an underpaid and overworked forklift instructor. I'm not insured against pirating.
I'll get our best sketch artist on this right away and see what we can do.
Aye, Mr. Heister, get out that map. Let's find our best way to the treasure.
Aaarrggh, Captain, if me calculate be correct, we be here. And the treasure be all the way over here marked with a red X.
Aye, but I think if we take this way, it'd be a shortcut.
Ah, a shortcut it may be, but it's also a pedestrian highway, and no forklifts are allowed.
We got a straight shot, eh?
Yeah, but that's a high traffic area, and navigating over choppy waters can be tricky. No, I think a better way will present itself. Right, Mr. Heistat?
Aaarrggh, and near it be, Captain. A wide channel through these rats. It'll give a safe passage to the treasure.
Aye. Let's weigh anchor and make our way to the treasure.
Aye, Captain.
Mr. Clark and Mr. Raymond, be sure to use your horns in this area when you traverse these waters. It alerts other travelers of your presence.
Aye.
Also be sure to stop at all major intersections. And look at those mirrors. And look both directions.
We'll hang you from the yard arm and send you to the briny deep.
Briny deep? What are the briny deep?
You'll find it out soon enough, you bill drag.
Haven't you been reading the definitions at the bottom of the screen as they appear?
Oh, I see. Briny deep. Another word for the ocean. What's a land lover again? Oh, wait. It says right here. Land lover. A person that lives on land, not the ocean. Fun word. Not really an insult. I get seasick anyway. Anyway, forklifts don't automatically get the right of way. It's a shared responsibility. You make eye contact, then you go with caution.
Put away your cutlasses, lads. They're right. Even though we be greedy pirates, we still have to share the seas with others. Now move along now so we can continue on our journey. Aaarrggh! Any of your boats need to stop?
Aaarrgh! We got it!
Now we got a treasure to find!
So, Captain, since we got past those sassy pants pedestrians, is there any other troubled waters we're gonna get into?
Well, it's my recollection, Sammy. I once traversed uncharted waters like these back in 85. Pallets sticking out at every turn. Damn it, loads as far as my eyes could see. And atrocious housekeeping that threatened to send us down to Davy Jones' locker if we weren't careful.
Aye, Captain. I'm not seeing any trouble in these waters now. Looks to me like we got a bunch of fine land lovers keeping the waters safe for everyone.
Aye, I think it'd be clear sailing all the way to the treasure.
Yeah.
But if you do find any troubles in these waters, make sure you tell the brawny, tough land lovers.
Brawny, tough landlubbers?
You know, the BTLs.
Pay attention, you dogs. We be nearing the treasure.
Aye, Captain, and there it be.
It's a treasure, lads. Just where I said it would be. And it's all for us.
Arrgh! You say they had swords and they called you landlubbers?
Landlubbers, actually, and I think one of them even called us bilge rats, whatever that means.
I even heard one of them call you sassy pants.
What?
I might have been mistaken. He might have been talking about somebody else. Sorry.
This is all sounding really familiar.
Lads, the time has come to collect our loot. Mr. Raymond, board that vessel and retrieve our loot.
Aye, Captain.
No, you swabby. You don't just start lifting the mast in the middle of nowhere. Are you sure you guys passed your warp drive wing lessons?
Aye, Captain.
Come on, do it right. You want to click.
Aye, listen to Captain. We've been waiting long enough.
First, grab the load of the truck. Then check for any overhead obstruction.
I'm going to buy a whole fleet of ships, my friend. want to be the most feared pirate of all the seas.
Now, Mr. Raven, you can begin raising your boat to the same level as the palace.
Aye, and I'm going to buy me an island and sit on the beach all day and drink those little coconut drinks with the pink straw and little hula dancers all over the place.
Once you get there, extend the forks all the way under the load and slightly tilt the forks if you wish. Now, slowly pull out the load by retracting the forks and gradually drop the load to the floor.
Yeah. Wait till we get our treasure.
Aye. This is it, lads. Treasures beyond our wildest dreams. We're all rich men indeed.
Sir, since this was your idea, you can be the first to open the chest.
Aye, aye, Captain. A golden forklift license.
Blimey, we risked our lives for this. Where's the treasure?
There ain't no gold, no silver, nothing.
Arrgh, we're not rich people indeed. Looks like we're going to have to back out to be a pirate again. No, that ain't such a bad life.
Ah, just disappointing to be sure. Now, back to the ship, you swabs. But before that, one more trip around the warehouse. Now, Mr. Claw, bring me that shipping dog. Hoist the main sail, me mates. It seems another adventure has found us. Yo-ho, me hearties! Yo-ho!
And ravage and don't give a hoot. Drink up, me hearties, yo ho. Yo ho, yo ho, a pirate's life for me.